여러분 반갑습니다. 지난 시간에 이어 오늘도 일성자유교양대학의 브루스 교수님 모시고 영어 잘하는 노하우 그리고 또 다른 영어 관련된 재미있는 컨텐츠 풀어가 볼게요.
What programs does Halim offer to help students improve their English?
Well, there's a good question. The number one program for students is the English Clinic. Okay, so what is the English Clinic? English Clinic, these are students who are chosen for their English ability and they are located in maybe certain rooms in different buildings all over this campus, okay? So a lot of them come from the pre-medical school and some come from other departments like life sciences or wherever. These are students who have good English ability, they've maybe lived abroad and their speaking is good, and their purpose is they're there to help students with whatever English problems they have. Sometimes students want to study more TOEIC, sometimes they just want to have conversations. Sometimes they have an assignment from their teacher where they have to interview someone and they don't know how to do it.
They can help you with your homework?
To a level. They can't do your homework for you, okay? That's not correct. But they can help you understand what the homework is and they can guide you through it. You know, they're not going to do your work for you. But the English Clinic is a very useful and very popular facility. It's a very popular service that we have here. So students should use that.
한림대학교에서 영어 클리닉이라는 걸 운영해서 영어를 나보다 잘하는 학생들에게 조금 영어에 대한 조언도 듣고 도움도 받을 수 있는 그런 프로그램이 있어요.
And I guess it's less stressful because you're learning from a fellow student.
Exactly. And it's always best to learn, obviously, from someone who speaks English better than you. And if it's a Korean student, then they can also explain some unusual or difficult things to you in Korean if it's necessary. So yeah, it's a win-win situation, right?
맞아요. 교수님한테 가는 것보단 조금 부담이 덜하지 않을까. 응? 같은 학생들로부터 조언을 구할 수 있으니까.
On top of that, we offer things like buddy programs or study abroad programs.
Buddy 프로그램이라고 해서 내가 조금 영어를 잘하고 싶다 하면 신청을 하면 돼요. 그래서 buddy가 되면 외국인 교환 학생과 매칭이 돼서 그 학생들과 같이 어울리면서 영어도 공부하고 그 학생들의 캠퍼스 라이프를 도와주고 뭐 그런 프로그램이 있어요.
I'm sure you've heard some positive feedback about the buddy program as well, right?
I actually, as I said in the introduction, I am the director of the Korean Studies program here. I teach a class that is almost all foreign students. And so every one of those foreign students has a buddy. And to be honest with you, I've heard nothing but good things about the buddy program. So there are students in there with different levels of English ability, but they're still able to help these foreign students do everything that they need to get done. So foreign students are usually very grateful. That's a good thing for a Korean student to do, is try to get into the buddy program, because that will definitely be a good opportunity to practice your English.
그 외에도 한림대학교와 교류하고 있는 세계의 대학교들이 굉장히 많아요. 여러 언어권에 영어권도 물론 있지만 뭐 프랑스어권, 중국어권, 일본어권 그런 학교들의 교환 학생으로 한 학기를 보내는 것도 또 언어 학습에 굉장히 많은 도움이 될 거예요.
Right? These study abroad programs, they offer great experience not just in terms of language learning but in terms of cultural experience.
Oh. Goodness, you go to another country, right? And it's a tremendous experience, right? So, and Halim has these kind of programs in countries all over the world. So once you get past this COVID-19 thing,
yeah,
then we can resume doing those. That's one of the best ways that you can get a great experience using your English language.
I would imagine that one question that is on a lot of students' mind would be, 아, 영어 공부 왜 해야 돼요? I'm not going to go anywhere. I'm going to live in Korea. I'm going to find a job in Korea. Why do I need to study English?
There are several reasons for that. Okay. The number one reason I get from students why they want to learn English is travel. Okay. Almost all students want to travel. And every year it seems more and more students want to do this. And if you're going to travel abroad, you need to know English because English is an international language of communication. It's also an international language of business.
Business, yes.
So if you know English, you can basically go nearly anywhere in the world and have a good experience, even if you don't learn the language of the place where you're going. Another reason why you need to learn English is TOEIC is king here.
Yes, it is a requirement for most jobs.
TOEIC is, right, it's a requirement for your employment. And although TOEIC study, I'll be honest, TOEIC study is extremely boring. it's boring for students, it's boring for teachers. Okay? Teachers don't really like to teach this, and students don't really like to. But if you know English well, you can do well in TOEIC.
Mm.
So you can do all of those things that I talked about before. You know, you can do the reading and study the collocations and practice speaking with a friend, do the English clinic. You practice and you study your English, not necessarily just studying TOEIC English, but just studying any English. Your TOEIC score is going to get better.
Mm.
It does. If your English is good, your TOEIC will be good too.
사실 그래요. 뭐 여행하고 싶어서 공부를 하는 친구들도 많지만 대부분은 이 취업 때문에 또는 토익이라는 시험을 봐야 되기 때문에 공부를 하는 경우가 많은데 이 시험을 목표로 공부를 하면 정말 공부가 재미가 없어요. 그러니까 그렇게 공부하는 것보다는 아까 브루스 교수님이 말씀해 주신 것처럼 하루에 조금씩이라도 읽기 습관을 들이면서 vocabulary도 늘리고 grammar도 늘리고 그렇게 해서 이미 내가 어느 정도의 영어에 대한 지식이 축적이 돼 있으면 따로 토익을 공부할 필요가 없는 거예요. You just have to study test taking techniques maybe. You know, solve a few test questions. Right?
Test taking skills are important to learn. That is one important thing of the TOEIC, how to take the test.
So take some sample tests and learn,
exactly.
Right?
Exactly. That is fairly easy enough to do. I mean, most students have attended a TOEIC hagwon or have done some sort of TOEIC study, whether before university or during their university time. So yeah, you do need to know the test-taking skills, but you don't necessarily just have to study only TOEIC English. Any English you study is going to help you.
이 시험에 따라서 문제 유형이 조금씩 다를 수는 있어요. 그래서 내가 이 시험을 보겠다, 토익을 보겠다 하면 토익에서 어떤 유형의 문제들이 나오는지 뭐 테스트로 몇 개 풀어보시는 정도로 하고 토익은 따로 공부하지 말고 평소에 영어를 늘리는 그런 습관을 가지면 좋을 것 같아요. Besides these tests like TOEIC or TOEFL, they're not really a completely accurate
It's not the way people communicate.
Right,
too much,
they don't necessarily reflect your true English abilities.
Well, right. TOEIC is designed, well, it's designed test of English for international mm-hmm. communication. But really what it is, it's business English. It's business related. And many students might look at the TOEIC and say, well, why am I studying this? Because my field is not business. This is all about working in an office or doing other things, and some of it is useful, but some of it maybe is not. So I understand their frustration, but again, there is usefulness in studying for the TOEIC, but if you know English, general English, for example, if you like to read English novels, English literature, that's going to help you with your TOEIC too. It will. All English that you study will help you with the TOEIC.
Because I've met people who had wonderful TOEIC or TOEFL scores, but couldn't speak.
Wonderful TOEIC scores. Yeah, really? Yeah, you can get a good score on something and then not speak it well. So most people don't study the TOEIC speaking. It's usually the listening and the reading, right? The LC and the RC.
네, 이런 시험하고 또 커뮤니케이션하고는 다른 거니까 꼭 시험을 위해서 영어를 공부한다 생각하지는 않았으면 좋겠어요. Let's lighten things up a little bit and do something fun.
Oh, fun is good.
Yes, and I thought
we'd
spend some time talking about Konglish.
Oh, yes. Konglish, the glorious Konglish.
Yes, yes. Konglish. Konglish 다 알죠, 여러분? 여러분들이 실제 생활에서 쓰고 있는 이런 단어들이 Konglish인지를 모르고 영어로 장문을 할 때나 대화를 할 때 이런 단어들이 툭툭 튀어나와요. 한번 보세요. Somebody's calling me to give me a morning call.
A morning call? Ah, a wake-up call.
Uh-huh.
A wake-up call.
So, a morning call이 아니고 wake-up call이라고 합니다. You go on the running machine.
The running machine. Machine that runs.
Running machine이라 그러면 기계가 뛰어다니는 그런 거예요, right?
It's called a treadmill.
Treadmill.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
Treadmill. That's the right.
To tread uh-huh. means to walk.
To walk.
It's a way
yes.
to say walk. T R E A D. Tread.
So you get into your open car.
Ah, your convertible.
Mm. Mm. Car without the hard top, right? With a
right.
soft top. Actually, British people call them soft tops.
Soft tops, right? So it's convertible means you can change it from
mm-hmm.
car with a top to car with no top. You can convert, right?
Right.
Conversion, right? So that's why it's called a convertible car. Okay, you can have top or no top.
Open car 아니고 convertible.
But an open car is easy to understand.
It's easy to understand
yeah.
too. And now you're hungry, so you go to a restaurant and you order a Set menu.
You must be in a fast food restaurant, I think. Okay, set menu in the United States where I come from, we say a combo.
A combo.
Yeah, so usually it's a sandwich and maybe some French fries and a drink or some other thing. All together it's called
combo. Is short for?
Combination.
Combination, 그렇죠? 이것저것 모아서 조합을 해서 만든 콤보라고 하지 세트 메뉴는 콩글리시라는 거 기억하시고요. So you're thirsty, you order a glass of cola, and you one-shot it.
You say bottoms up. We say bottoms up.
One shot 아니고 bottoms up. You drink it bottoms up.
Really, you drink it the whole thing at one time.
Bottoms, 밑바닥이 위로 올라가는 거죠. That's one shot. One shot in Korean. So I'm done checking my social media. Now I want to study so I can improve my specs.
Your specs. Your spec is usually short for specification. But what we really mean is qualification. Right? Your abilities and skills that you have acquired for over some time.
자, 우리가 흔히 얘기하는 스펙 올리기. 이때 스펙은 스페시피케이션에서 나온 줄임말이긴 하지만 스페시피케이션도 정확한 표현은 아니고 나의 퀄리피케이션을 높인다고 얘기를 해야 돼요. You're proud of yourself because you're studying and you tell yourself fighting.
You say go. Or let's go.
Go, yeah. Let's go, right? Or it's saying fighting to somebody who's about to take their exam, it means good luck.
Right, good luck. Yeah, then. I wish you well.
So, 이렇게 해서 한림 공식 유튜브 채널을 통해서 학생들 여러분들과 만나봤어요. 지금 다들 어려운 시기일 거라고 짐작은 하는데 we are trying to practice 사회적 거리두기
social distancing. So we keep about 2 meters or more apart, right? Because of the COVID-19 problem.
And our students stay home, and we are on campus trying to teach our students online
in a virtual way.
Yes, yes. 이렇게 사회적 거리두기를 social distancing이라고 하는데 이런 것 때문에 여러분들 조금 힘들겠지만. Fighting 하자고요.
Good luck.
Good luck. Right? Let's go. 잘해봅시다. 이런 의미예요. 자, 한림 공식 유튜브 채널 앞으로도 계속 여러분들을 위한 콘텐츠 많이 올라올 테니까 구독, 좋아요 꼭 눌러주시고 또 다음에 기회가 되면 여러분들 만나요. 곧 캠퍼스에서 뵙게 되기도 바랄게요. Thank you very much, guys.
Yeah, thank you and hope to see you on campus sometime.